हेलो गाइस, दिस इज स्टेनो फॉर ऑल यूट्यूब चैनल। हियर वी प्रोवाइड यू हिंदी और इंग्लिश शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस एट डिफरेंट स्पीड। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू इंग्लिश डिक्टेशन एट द स्पीड ऑफ 80, विच विल हेल्प यू इन वेरियस स्टेनो स्किल टेस्ट्स।
गेट रेडी फॉर 80 वर्ड पर मिनट शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन। स्टार्ट। द न्यू नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी NEP 2020 एम्स टू प्रोवाइड यूनिवर्सल एक्सेस टू क्वालिटी एजुकेशन एंड ब्रिज द गैप बिटवीन द करंट स्टेट ऑफ लर्निंग आउटकम्स एंड व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड थ्रू अंडरटेकिंग मेजर रिफॉर्म्स दैट ब्रिंग द हाइएस्ट क्वालिटी equity and integrity into the system from early childhood care and education through higher education. It suggests that where it differs from previous policies is that in addition to the issues of access and equity, the present policy lays an emphasis on quality and holistic learning. The outcome sought in higher education is more than the creation of greater opportunities for individual employment. It represents the key to more vibrant, socially engaged, cooperative communities and a happier, cohesive, cultured, productive, innovative, progressive, and prosperous nation. In a brief paragraph on medical education, it states that the aim is to train healthcare professionals primarily required for working in primary care and secondary hospitals on private entities. Successive governments have been faced with the quandary of how to quickly expand educational opportunities while simultaneously addressing the issues of quality and equity. In the field of healthcare, there is a continuing shortage of healthcare personnel. The infrastructure required for high quality modern medical education is expensive. Faced with public demand for high quality medical care on the one hand and severe constraints on public resources on the other, private entities have been permitted to establish medical educational institutions to supplement government efforts, though they are supposed to be not for profit, taking advantage of the poor regulatory apparatus and the ability to both tweak and create rules. These private entities, with very few exceptions, completely commercialized education. None of the three stated objectives of medical education has been achieved by the private sector, that is, providing healthcare personnel in all parts of the country, ensuring quality and improving equity. The overwhelming majority of private medical colleges provide poor quality education at extremely high costs. Faced with this situation, the public has approached the polity, the executive, and the courts to ensure equity, if not quality. The results have been patchy. On and off, there have been attempts to regulate fees. sometimes by governments and sometimes by courts. Faced with the fundamental contradiction that all governments have been complicit in violations of their own policies to ensure quality as well as equity, these efforts have not been fruitful. The executive, primarily the Medical Council of India, has proven unequal to the task of ensuring that private institutions comply with regulations. When the courts are approached, which issues are seen as important depends on the bench. Some judges wish to ensure quality and equity. Others give importance to points of law on the rights of private parties, federalism, and such issues. It was in this situation that the Board of Governors, which replaced the Medical Council of India as an interim before the National Medical Commission became operative, introduced the National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test undergraduate or NEET UG as a single All India gateway for admission to medical colleges. It is well known, though not easy to prove, that entrance examinations being held by almost all private colleges were a farce and seats were being sold to the higher bidder. Challenged in courts after an initial setback, the NEET scheme has been upheld. India's growth in the first quarter of 2020-21 at 23.9% showed one of the highest contractions globally. Global growth prospects for 2020 have been projected by a number of multilateral institutions and rating agencies, including that for India. The 2020-21 real GDP growth for India is forecasted in the range of -5.8%. The Reserve Bank of India's survey of professional forecasters to -14.8%, Goldman Sachs. The Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, in its September 2020 interim economic outlook has projected a contraction of -10.2% in financial year 2021 for India. The annual projections also indicate a strong likelihood of even the nominal GDP growth showing a contraction for 2020-21. The latest data released by the Ministry of Statistics indicate a consumer price index CPI inflation rate of 6.7% for August 2020. The average CPI inflation during the first 5 months of 2020-21 is estimated at 6.6%. Given the injection of periodic liquidity into the system and the inflation trends, the year as a whole may show a CPI inflation of close to 7%. Since deflator-based inflation tends to be lower than the CPI inflation, it may be about 5% or less. In fact, in the first quarter of 2020-21, the GDP based deflator was only 1.8%. If we take the OECD's real GDP growth projection at -10.2% and a deflator based inflation of about 5%, the implied contraction in nominal GDP is about -5.0% for 2020-21. It is true that some of us felt at one time that the economy might not do too badly because some key factors.